What's up guys, in this tutorial I will show you the best settings in Honkai Star Rail for low-end PCs and laptops to fix lag, keep a high frame rate and still run the game with decent visual quality. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. Navigate to your in-game settings. I will set these options for low-end PCs. If you're using a newer PC, then you might want to increase these next options slightly. Set the graphics quality preset to low. This should reduce the other options below. The resolution option should be set to your native monitor resolution. You can verify your native resolution in your Windows display settings. Set the in-game frame rate to 60. There are ways to uncap your frame rate for Honkai Star Rail, but it will in turn lower your overall performance. Disable vertical sync and set the rendering quality or the render scale to 1 for now. If you experience low performance after applying the next steps, then you might want to lower the rendering quality option to around 80%. I prefer to completely disable shadows, set the reflection quality to low and set the character quality to medium, environment detail to low, bloom effect to low, anti-aliasing to FXAA and the light quality option to medium. After applying your changes, you should see an increase in overall performance for Honkai Star Rail. You can also preview your current ping or latency to the game server on the top right of your screen. If you want to see your frame rate in the game, then you will have to make use of an FPS counter, such as the one from MSI Afterburner or simply the Windows Game Bar FPS counter. Use the Windows key and the G shortcut to toggle this overlay. Toggle the performance widget by selecting it in your top menu, and a new window will open up. You can pin this window anywhere on your screen so that it remains visible when the overlay is disabled. You also have the option to show your GPU, CPU, VRAM and RAM usage when playing Honkai Star Rail. If the FPS value remains unchanged, then you will be required to restart the game. These steps and more information will be available in my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.